वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर इन सिग्नल एंड सिस्टम्स। वी आर स्टडिंग सिग्नल रिकंस्ट्रक्शन यूजिंग फर्स्ट ऑर्डर होल्ड। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव सीन दैट यूजिंग अ ट्राइंगुलर पल्स एज अ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर होल्ड वी विल रिकंस्ट्रक्ट our signal as a piecewise linear approximation of the original signal. The calculation you can see here. Today we will determine the transfer function for this first order hold circuit. So the first order hold circuit is represented by its impulse response HT which is equal to triangular pulse to determine HS which is the transfer function for this first order hold. Let us quickly see what will be the Fourier transform H omega for a triangular pulse will be equal to T sample square omega T divided by 2. So we know that sin C function is equal to sin pi t divided by pi t which is also equal to sample pi t so taking our h omega which is sample square omega I will write omega as 2 pi f t so it will become 4 h omega will become t sample square 2 pi f t. As you can see sample pi t can be written in term of sine sorry there we will write t divided by 2 so the 2 will cancel it will become t sample square pi f t which will become t So I will use this formula here that simple. Pi t will be equal to sine pi t divided by pi t. So here we will have sample pi f t, so it will become sine pi f t divided by pi f t whole square. Also, I can write sine function in terms of exponential as t multiplied by e to the power j pi f t minus e to the power minus j pi f t divided by 2 iota. So we'll have in denominator 2 i or 2 j pi f t, we will have whole square. Replacing s is equal to j omega here, or s is equal to j 2 pi f. So you can see that it will become this thing is done to get h s from h omega. So when we replace s by j 2 pi f, then we will have h s here. It is h omega. And finally, we will get t multiplied by e to the power, if we replace j pi f, then we will have here s t by 2 minus e to the power minus s t by 2 divided by 2 pi f is s, and denominator we have s t square. So this will be our transfer function for the triangular pulse. So here we can represent it as xt which is our continuous time signal. After successful sampling, we have converted the signal to st. When this st signal is passed through a first order hold circuit, we get x naught t, where the first order hold is represented by e to the power st by 2 minus e to the power minus st by 2 divided by st whole square. So in this way we have determined hs, which is the transfer function for first order hold. So in this video lecture, we have covered the transfer function for first order whole circuit. So let us quickly revise what we have learned. We have learned that a first order whole circuit, which is represented by a triangular pulse, when convoluted with our sample signal, we get the successful recovery of the signal as x naught t, which is a piecewise linear approximation of to the original signal. It is the calculation for ST, which you have seen in your previous lectures. After that, we have developed the linear approximation. Here, we want to determine the transfer function. Then first, we will use the Fourier transform, H omega for triangular pulse, which is capital T, sample square, omega T by 2. And using these identities for sin C and sampling function, we have developed that H omega is equal to T e to the power j pi f t minus e to the power minus j pi f t divided by 2 j pi f t square. After replacing S by j omega or j 2 pi f to get Laplace transform from Fourier transform, we have found that Hs is equal to T e to the power st by 2 minus e to the power minus st by 2 divided by st square, which I replaced in our original diagram. And in this way, we have developed the transfer function for the first order hold. So this is all for the today's video lecture. I hope you will enjoy this video. For any query, you can visit our Google Classroom for Signal in Systems, and you can put your queries so that the topic will be clear to you. Till then, stay tuned for upcoming video lectures, and thank you very much.